What's up, guys? Nepenthes here, and welcome back to another episode of The Road to Glory. Today, I've invested some coins both for profit and for fun. We've bought a couple of Team of the Season players, an icon, a man of the match, and an inform for today's squad builder. I have already got some players that we've had in the club to use because there was only a couple of players I thought, let me try these two in a squad and then how can I link them? And it was pretty easy to link them, turns out. But before we get into that, I want to show you guys what I've invested a lot of my funds in. So you can see we're down to 5.3 million coins. I picked up a lot of Team of the Season cards for way lower than what they're going for. I've got them all listed up currently. Well, a few of them not, but you'll see in a second. A few of them listed up for basically to end at about 6:05. Now, by the time you're watching this video, this will already be yesterday's 6 p.m. Because we're obviously expecting a SBC for Team of the Season at 6 p.m. And if it does require a Team of the Season card, these player prices might spike periodically. They might just generally trend up. But I've invested a hell of a lot of coins in. So we picked up a Snodgrass for 24k. He's selling for 28,000 anyway, so I could make a nice few thousand profit on him. We got Key for 20,500 and another Key for 20,500, and he discards for like 19,000 something. We've already talked about obviously Team of the Season investing, but we've got an 81 Henderson for 22,500, and then we got lots more. So I also got Van Ginkel, who actually was in today's squad, but I've got him on the transfer list because I bought him for 62k and I sniped him and I wanted to sell him before 6 p.m. because he's a most consistent player. And the problem with that is that the SBC that comes out today at 6 p.m. is probably going to be a most consistent SBC, which is going to really drop the price of most consistent players. And as luck would have it, well, my luck anyway, he's actually already down to 57k. So I sniped him for 2k cheaper. I played 5 games with him, and then he's already lost like 5, 6, 7,000 coins value. But hey, we played games with him. That was the point, right? It doesn't matter if I lost 5 or 10k. The purpose of buying him to use him was to use him, not to worry about the few k that we might lose, because we're going to make way more than that off the players that we bought. And as you can see then, I've got 9 carries on the trade pile. Some of them bought for as much as 22,500. Most of them bought for 21,000 or less. And I believe this guy discards for 19,800 and something. And his lowest bin right now is 24k. But as you can see, I've got him up at 28k for either lazy buyers or if something comes at 6. And if nothing comes, I'll just list them all up for 24k. And it'll be like 2k a card, but it'll still be pretty decent. But yeah, so we've got one for 21, one for 20,250, another one for 21, another one for 22, another one for 20,250, 22, 22 again, 20,250. 21,750, and then back to Van Ginkel. And then on the next page, we have more carries, 22,750 on that one. That was, I probably overpaid for that. I got him only 1,000 coins less than what he's actually going for anyway. But another 20,750, another one up at 23K, and another one up at 23K. And then we got some Mulgrews. So I moved into the Mulgrew market. So Charlie Mulgrew right now, I believe his lowest bin is about 26K. According to Futbin, it is exactly 26k, and there's only two of them at 26k, and then it moves up. And I picked up this one for 22,750, this one for 24,500. And the idea behind this, you know, paying as much as 24,500 for them is that if a Team of the Season SBC does require a Team of the Season card, at 85 rated, he will definitely be a usable option, a viable option. You know, maybe the 83s and 81s, if it's an 84 rated squad, they might not be as usable as an 85. So if he is required, he'll go up to like 29, 30,000 coins. And if he's not required, 24K, 25K is low for what he is and who he is. So I'll be able to sell him for 27, 28 anyway, with his low bin being 26 to lazy buyers. So I'll still be able to make some good profit regardless. But I didn't get too many at 24,500. As you can see, we've got one for 22,750, one for 24K, one for 22K, one for 20,750, which is obviously super, super cheap. And then another one for 22,750. And then as we move on to the next page, we've got another Mulgrew for 22,500. Then I moved into the Jota market. So we got him for 25,500 or less. And he's currently like 27,500. Actually, it looks like his price is coming down as well. Maybe people are panic selling in anticipation for this SBC at 6 p.m. I don't know. But we've got him for 25,500, 25,750, and 25,000. and then 25,500. And that was me buying him. Like, honestly, I was sniping him 8 to 10 minutes ago. I was sniping him for that when he was selling for 28,000. So the fact now, oh, well, it says he's 25,000 low bin, but actually that is the one lowest bin. And then the next one is 26,500. So I have still got him like 1,000 coins cheaper or so, but I'd have to sell him for a bit more to be able to get some money back. Fortunately, I only bought 4 of these. So, you know, even if we just lose tax by selling these back on, we're only going to lose, what, like 5,000 coins over all 4 cards, which isn't too bad. Then I bought 3 Robert Snodgrass, one for 26,000. He's currently selling for 28,500 is his low bin. So I've got one for 26K, one for 25K, and then one for 23,750. So for 87 rated cards, that is an absolute bargain. So obviously assume that we know that it's going to be Van Ginkel, guys, that is one of the players in this squad. We'll put a concept player in there just so that you can see what team we're working with. So Van Ginkel goes into that midfield role for us. In at the goalkeeper spot, guys, I actually went and bought an icon goalkeeper. I went and bought Schmeichel. I don't particularly like the icon goalkeepers. I don't think they're worth it. But the reason why I bought Schmeichel was twofold. Number one, at 248,000 coins, he was not only the cheapest icon by 12,000, but he was the cheapest goalkeeper icon by 22,000. The next cheapest goalkeeper icon was 270,000 coins. I don't know if that's just because it was the time of day that I was looking or what, but yeah, as you can see, I bought him for 248. I think I've been like transfer market banned because of what I've been buying and stuff. But I bought Peter Schmeichel for 248, and according to FUTBIN, 261 is his next lowest bin, and then 275 is his next lowest bin. But the other reason why I'm happy to pick him up is because I needed an icon anyway to complete Ruud Gullit. And Ruud Gullit is definitely something I'm going to be working on over the next few days. We've obviously done the first icon part. We've done a few of these ones. We've got the 89 rated squad all but finished. I just need to figure out who I do want to trade in and who I don't want to trade in. And then we'll go and get that, because I really might keep Zanetti. He's just a good link to a lot of cards. And he's a really, really good card himself. I don't know if I want to keep Zanetti or not. And then also, as crazy as this is going to sound, Rijkaard and Costa, I don't know if I want to get rid of any of these three icons. I suppose I feel attached to them because I crafted them rather than anything else. But also, all three of them are still viable and usable at this stage in FIFA. More specifically, Rijkaard and Zanetti. Well, I'd say in order of actual usability, Zanetti is the most usable card. Rijkaard is the second most usable card. And then Rui Costa afterwards. But Rui Costa for me has been great. I like his in-game stats. I like him as a player. I don't know if I want to get rid of these cards. But of course, we need to throw an icon in there. Now, Schmeichel wasn't bought for this team. Of course, we could potentially use Zanetti. We could not. I don't know if I'm going to or not. Schmeichel was bought for this team. Although I need an 88 rated squad, you only need one icon in this. So the fact that I've got him for super cheap, we'll be able to throw him in there, guys. That's the icon done. Then we just need to get an 88 rated squad around him. And that'll be that. And I'm happy with how little this Ruud Gullit is actually going to cost me. I genuinely believe that after we get everything back from the packs that we open, and after we take into consideration how cheap we got Henrik Larsson, how cheap we got Zanetti, should we use him, we're actually going to be spending way less than 1 million coins for this Ruud Gullit. And so I am super, super excited to get him into the squad. Something sold. Be one of the blue cards. There you go. That Snodgrass that we picked up for, what was that, 22,750, or maybe, which one was that? So 26K for that Snodgrass. Yeah, so we bought that Snodgrass, what was it, 23,750, something like that. So we already made like a nice bit of profit on that, which covers the losses of any of these that we've overpaid for, and also covers some of the losses for that Van Ginkel that we've had in our squad build for today. In at the right wing spot, guys, I went and got a player that everybody rants and raves about that I have never used this year in FIFA. I might have bought him once. I can't remember. I don't think I've used him. He did all right for us in the 5 games as well. 5 goals and 3 assists, so very nice from him. Up front, guys, I went and bought man of the match, Robin van Persie. So he connects in with Rijkaard and Lozano to get perfect chemistry. And then in at left wing, I went and bought Jota. Because like I say, I wanted to try a few new players. You know, I took on board some comments from the previous few videos and stuff. And, you know, we got to team of the season. And I can both spend and lose money a little bit on coins from these team of the season cards and still invest and grind to earn coins. We've got so many coins now that we can actually afford to do both. However, I'll spend big, like real big, when the big team of the season comes out and we want to put those players in our club. So we bought this Jota as well for 25,750. I bought Robin Van Persie for 15k on open bid. I think he discards for, the same. So the only thing it cost me is the position change, which is pretty good. And I bought Lozano for 35,500. I don't know what he's going for right now. I genuinely must be transfer banned because I can't even compare prices on transfer market. And then outside of that, I still have a whole bunch of team of the season cards here as well that we picked up. Mulgrew, Dak, Pittman. Pittman right now, I bought for 22k. He's selling right now for like 26k for some reason. I'm not quite sure why he's so expensive. Yeah, he's legit 26k. So that's not bad. He might be one. Can I sell? Even though I can't compare, can I sell him? If I can list him up for 26k, I'll actually take the money back for that. Okay, so I could. So that's pretty decent. But yeah, generally speaking, guys, and Powell as well. What did I buy for him for? 20,750 for this Powell card. And he is selling for some reason as well, at like 26,000 as well. Yeah, he is also 26,000. So I'm going to list him up too. And make some good profit off of him. And it's going to be so easy throughout the whole team of the season making good profit off of these guys. Mulgrew again for 22k, Bradley Dack for 22k, Carey for 21,750, Henderson for 20k, Key for 19,000, Sheehan for 19,000, Issa for 20,000. We bought Berge, as I believe, for 20,000 as well. 18,750. I think he discards for what I bought him for. Anyway, I've been through this anyway. But what I wanted to show you guys was the squad that we're using. I'm going to be playing 4-1-2-1-2 narrow with this. I'll show you what it actually looked like in-game so that you get an understanding of how I was playing. So, as per usual, we swapped around Pereira and Rijkaard because Rijkaard, much better centre-back than Pereira. Pereira's a solid CDM. Rui Costa came into the left centre mid spot, and then Jota and Van Persie swapped like that. So that's how this team looked in game. And yeah, let's go and get into some of the gameplay and see how it played. I will be right back. Before we get into the gameplay, guys, at 6 p.m, EA have released a couple of SBCs, the Community Team of the Season, EFL Team of the Season SBCs. We're not going to do these here today. We're going to do those at the start of tomorrow's video. So tune back in for that. But my God, did I make a lot of coins. And not even as much as I could have made. I sold those, I listed those cards up just in hopeful grasp that they'd sell for more than they are. And every single team of the season card right now is about 30 to 33,000 coins that was less than. So all of these that sold for like 26s and 28s and stuff, I could easily have squeezed a few more thousand coins out of those. But I'm happy with the profit. It's a minimum of 5,000 coins per card here. And I had pages and pages and pages of them. As you guys well know, we listed them up like, you know, even like these ones are really frustrating, the 25k ones, because Powell's up at 30k now. Henderson is up at 30k now. So yeah, could have made a little bit more coins out of this, but man, what a good set of purchases they were. Every single card sold. I sold everything out of my club as well. There's a few on the trade pile still. So we're going to clear that away. So we've got Mulgrew, Dak, Henderson at 35k. I don't know why I put him up there. And then Sheehan. As you can see, Sheehan's not selling at 31,500, which means 30,000 seems to be about the threshold for those Team of the Season cards. And rest assured, they will continue to decline. They will come back down towards the 27, 28, 26k mark. And then when we look at my actual club, I've only got the two left. And I've saved these two because I'm going to use these two to do the two for me. Two of the lower rated ones that cost me nothing, 20,000 and 19,000. So 39,000 coins for the pair of those. I've already got all the 81s and 80s that are that I'm needed to go into getting those SBCs done. I could use the untradeable guy, but because these two Team of the Seasons are 81 rated with a Team of the Season card, I'm worried that like the Premier League one might be an 84 rated or an 85 rated with the Team of the Season card. So I'm going to save that guy for the time being. But yeah, guys, that was just some absolutely mental profit made. We're up to almost 6.3 million coins now. I probably made somewhere around the region of about 200,000 coins right there. 150, maybe after tax. Maybe as low as 120 after tax. But a really, really good set of investments there. Fantastic. Super happy with that. And yeah, no complaints at all about that right there. But let's go and get into this gameplay from FUT Champs, guys. I will be right back. Okay, guys, so into the gameplay we go. Five games of Foot Champs with this team. I think five games is a fair amount of games to play with a squad with a new player, new team of season player. I think it will give us a good feel for how well they're going to play, how they're going to play. And to start things off, I'll say Jota, the left wing, not very good. Not worth your coins, especially now that his prices are... gone up massively because of the SBC. I assume that the prices of these players will come back down, but you know, right now he's selling for 34,000 coins and he was at like 27,000. So, like, I would say though, if you can get him for like 27, 26k, he is a good player. You know, he has good stats. He's got, you know, well rounded dribbling, good shooting, good pace. He's four star, so he's got a lot going for him positively and he's got decent composure. But he just didn't get involved in the game. Like, he very rarely scored goals. I don't think he got any assists. I think he got two goals in five games and no assists. And, yeah, just generally speaking, it was hard to find him in the game. Like, every time a goal was scored or every time a chance was created, he was nowhere to be seen. So I would say for Jota, not worth your time. However, Van Ginkel was noticeable in the midfield. Now, I think he got three goals in the five games and no assists. However, him coming in at like a 6 foot tall or a 6'1", 6'1 powerhouse with really good stats. And I actually put Engine on him. And the reason why I put Engine on him and not something for defensive stats is because the balance and agility upgrade is nice. The ball control upgrade is nice. The pace and passing upgrade is nice. And if you actually look at his defensive stats, he's got really good stand tackle and decent interceptions to start with. So I feel like it would be a waste to give him a defensive boost unless you're using him as a CDM. If you use him as a box-to-box midfielder, I think he's actually already good. Another thing that I loved about him, obviously, he's got four-star weak foot, which is great. He's got three-star skill moves, which is good enough. But yeah, Van Ginkel was good. And he's right now, he's worth 55,000 coins. I bought him for 63k. He's worth, at the time of making this video, 55k. I would definitely say he's absolutely worth your funds. He was a solid player to play with. He was really fun, scored some good important goals, and just generally speaking was all right. So into the comments, guys. The Diamond Hassel says, are you going to start doing player reviews for Team of the Season players like Bobby Reed and Hamsik, Fabinho, Malcolm, and then tell us if they're worth it? Player reviews, probably not. Not like dedicated reviews. But what I will be doing over the course of Team of the Season is building squads with 1, 2, 3, 4 Team of the Season cards in, maybe even 6 or 7, maybe a full Team of the Season squad, and then telling you which ones stood out and which ones didn't, which ones were value for money and which ones weren't. But there won't be like a specific, like, you know, this video here isn't a Van Ginkel player review or a Jota player review. This is just a team with both of those in the team and me trying to figure out if they're good, great, bad, worth it, not worth it, do they stand out or not. And that's a perfect example of why Van Ginkel is good. He held off three tackles there, great finish from the top of the box, and just generally shows how much of a beast he is. So yeah, there won't be specific reviews per se, but there will be lots of Team of the Season squad builders built and lots of gameplay with that. CafRawy5 says, you stop playing Foot Champs, saved your coins for Team of the Season, and you end up buying a 200k team. That's not what I waited for, Nip. That's too bad for you. That's literally too bad for you. I'm not just going to go all in and buy every single most consistent Team of the Season player on day one. When I bought three Team of the Year players on day one, I got crucified for doing so. This time, I'm picking and choosing who I'm buying and when, and we're going to have fun with it still. You know, we're not going to just go out and buy every single Team of the Season player and just burn all those coins that we've been saving up for. And this is the most consistent Team of the Season. Wait for the Premier League, the Eredivisie, etc., so on and so forth. They will come. There's a comment from Aaron Briggs says, what is this about no Eredivisie, Portuguese League, etc. in packs and just been released as an SBC card? I don't know where this came from. Like, the rest of the world Team of the Season is the top 50 players that are going to be released in SBC and daily and objectives, right? That's fine. However, that doesn't immediately mean that there will be no other minor leagues. From my personal opinion, we will still get an Eredivisie Team of the Season. We will get a Russian League Team of the Season. We will get a... what are the other ones that we're going to get that aren't... Because we've already got one minor Team of the Season, right? We've already got the EFL Team of the Season. So it is of my opinion that we will get the Turkish League, the Russian League, the Eredivisie, and what was the last one that I thought we were going to... The Portuguese League, the Liga NOS. So I think those four Team of the Seasons will still come once per week with the 4 weeks worth of major Team of the Seasons left to come. So next week is Premier League, the week after will be La Liga, the week after will be Bundesliga, then the week after that will be Calcio A and Serie A together. in those 4 weeks, we've already had the minor league EFL team of the season. So in those 4 weeks, I feel like we'll also get the Liga NOS, the Russian League, the Super League, and the Eredivisie. That's my opinion. Last year, we had more than four minor leagues team of the seasons. We had the Saudi League, we had the Pro League, and so on and so forth. But these leagues are represented in the top 50 rest of the world already, which means that they're not going to get their own individual league. However, none of the four leagues that I just announced have been released in the first 10 of the top 50. And there is no way on earth that there are only 40 spots left to cover all of the rest of the world team of the seasons if they don't do any more minor league team of the seasons, which means there's definitely going to be four minor leagues, in my personal opinion. I don't know this for a fact, that's just my opinion. Now, I was 4-3 up against this guy, and I made a mistake, and the game made a mistake right here. The game should have been over, I should have just cleared that, I should have won that game. I end up tying 4-4 late on. The 2 minutes of injury time had lasted for so long. However, that was absolutely my mistake for not just punting the ball clear. I did everything right there. I held onto the ball, I won a foul up the top left. I played it safely back to the goalkeeper, and the right choice would have been just punting that up the field, getting the final whistle blown and walking away with a win. Well, actually, I ended up losing on penalties. He saved my third penalty and my first penalty. I stood the right direction for two of his penalties, and I dived the right direction for his final penalty, and I saved none of them. Watch the way I stand. Look at that. I dived underneath, and I dived and the ball went underneath Schmeichel. But here's where it's frustrating and understandable and explains a lot of people's problems in this game with auto-passing and why people are like, I didn't pass there, I didn't do that, I didn't do this. And I want to show this because I know where I aimed this. And you'll see here, I aimed this heavy left towards my left back. I didn't put much power on it, sure, but I thought that would still go up towards the far side to where my left back was standing. You can see my left back out there. You can see the auto-passing feature has Frank Rijkaard selected, which means the game has decided that the most logical pass from this position is Rijkaard. And so even though I've aimed it towards the left-hand side, towards the left back spot, it passes it directly towards his player. And that is both a curse and a bonus for auto-passing, because there are times where it benefits you because you don't, like, you know, you don't aim perfectly and auto-passing takes over. But there are times where it screws you. First and foremost, I take on board that was my mistake. I didn't have to pass that. I didn't have to pass it that direction. I could have passed it towards the right back. But once I passed it back to the goalkeeper, I should have punted it up the field. It would have been full time. That would have been game over. So I take responsibility for that. But that is a game I should have won. 4-3 up after coming back from 3-1 down. Generally played quite well against a full Prime Icon Player of the Year team. I thought I did well to come away with that, and then unlucky to lose on penalties. You know, penalties is just a coin toss anyway. But yeah, that was I looked at that, and I, for a change, because I'm not taking Foot Champ seriously, I came out of that, and all I did was look at that and think, okay, next time I'll be far more aware of the fact that I'll either need to put more power on the pass to get it up to my left back, or I'll just punt it clear. Lesson learned. I won't do that again. That's never going to cost me a goal again by trying to be smart with the goalkeeper. And essentially, lesson has absolutely been learned. But yeah, in terms of the minor league team of the seasons, I do expect we will get four. And the reason, again, just to compound why I think we'll get four, is because if you look at some of the minor leagues from the rest of world team of the season, they've got the Spanish second league in there. They've got the Polish league in there. Like, they've got some leagues in there where there's no way that in 40 spaces that are left available, they're going to put in the Russian league, the Portuguese league, the Turkish league, the Dutch league. There's no way. So for those that are thinking, oh, I'm going to unlock Lozano in an objective or from an SBC, I don't think that's going to be the case. I think Lozano will be in the Eredivisie team of the season that will come out alongside one of the major team of the seasons, either next Friday, the Friday after, the Friday after, or the Friday after. That's my personal opinion. Two more comments. Mitchell says, hey, Nap, I'm looking to buy team of the season Alejandro Gomez, but I don't know when to buy. Should I buy him now or wait till lightning rounds, even wait till the Calcio A team of the season is fully released? By the way, love your vids. I tell you what, dude, probably now is a good time to buy him. You might lose some coins on him over the course of team of the season, but at 300k for a card that good, he won't go much cheaper. He might go down into the 200s eventually over time. But this is an end game card for 300,000 coins. And the reason why I'd say it's probably worth picking him up now is because once he's out of PAX on Friday, he's not back in PAX again for 4 weeks. Because he will be in the Calcio UA team of the season, which is the last one with the French League team of the season. So it's going to be a case of, if you buy him now, you'll get a full 4 or 5 weeks worth of playtime with him before his price really starts to plummet, because he's in team of the season packs again. And because of these SBCs that are coming out, and because everyone's like getting involved and stuff, I think he's good value at 300k. For a card that good, as I say, he might drop down to 250, 220, 200 over the course of the rest of the year. But I think this is as good a time as any to pick him up. And then last but not least, no creativity to think of a proper name. Says, Hynep, when are you going to do Hullet? He's down to 2 mil, so he basically can't drop much more. Also, would you prefer Van Ginkel team of the season or Boateng team of the season right centre mid? Love the vids and thank you for featuring me so often. Well, welcome back again. I thoroughly enjoyed Van Ginkel. I will also be putting Boateng into a team as well. So I'll test him out and I'll be able to give you a better idea. But in terms of when I'm going to complete Hullet, quite soon. I feel like quite soon, because yeah, according to Futbin, he's down at 2 million on PlayStation. And of course I've already got a lot of that completed, and I don't know. It's probably going to cost me less than 1 million coins to complete Ruud Gullit. So it might be good to have him in the team ASAP. Maybe I'll do it this week at some stage or another. But that, guys, is going to be the end of the video, the end of the gameplay there. We've got 4 wins and that 1 penalty loss in a game that I could potentially have won. So quite happy with how the team played. Obviously, it's not a meta team. It's got some meta players in it, but it's not a meta team. So to come away in foot champs with 4 wins and a loss with that team, I was super happy with that. This, though, is going to be the end of the video for now, guys. If you did enjoy this, be sure to leave a like, rating, comment, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. But for now, guys, I'm out. Peace.